Now for the actual video.
Good morning. It is morning time. Niagara Day. The sun is just rising now.
Okay, so right now we have passed like about halfway to Niagara, and Dad won't stop laughing at me filming this, but ignore that. We stopped by CVS to grab a few things, and I realized that I took my makeup. I forgot foundation, and I have all my other makeup, but I really needed foundation because if you get it, you get it, you know? And so basically we also wanted to just stop to get a few snacks. Yeah, that's about it. I will keep y'all updated. So we're about 5 minutes away now from the place, and of course you know that I'm gonna be prepared. I have my notes about the place and just questions, answers, things that you guys might be curious about. So do you have to pay for things there? The falls themselves, since it is a natural open space to the public, it's free, but you do have to pay for the attractions, which I'm going to be showing throughout the video. Are there night lights and like LED lights by the falls? And if you guys have heard of that, yes, there are every single night, which hopefully we're going to get to see as well tonight. What are the names of the falls? So there are three. There's the American, the Bridal Veil Falls, and then also the Horseshoe Falls, which is on the Canadian side. A few more really quick questions are about vaccinations. So I read that you have to be vaccinated in order to cross over to the Canadian side, and also it is important to keep in mind that you do need a passport to show proof of yourself, but I didn't see anything saying that you need to have all that for you to go from Canada to America. And there's also a few facts that I personally found interesting that I want to share with you guys. So the falls are almost 12,000 years old. More than 6 million cubic feet of water go over the Horseshoe Falls every single minute. The falls height ranges from 70 feet to 110 feet, depending on, of course, which waterfall you're looking at. So those are just a few of the things, but I thought that was pretty interesting. The lashes are giving. I hope you feel the same, by the way I feel about you. Okay, hi guys! So, I'm here with my lovely mom, and update about today. So, we ended up going and finding $25 parking, which is really good, it's for the whole day. And then we grabbed food at a nearby court, and we stopped by and saw this gentleman who was answering questions and also booking tours. And we found out that it's way more convenient to book a tour, like a guided tour, and it'll take you to all the places. So we're just walking around now. The tour starts at 5:30, so it's a little bit later than we expected. But at the same time, now we have some time to go check out some free things to do as well. So I will keep y'all posted. Since we had a few more hours until our tour were to begin, we decided to walk through Niagara Falls State Park, and there we were actually able to see Niagara Falls already from a view nearby the observatory deck, along with the Maid of the Mist ships and where we will be boarding later. There you can see the American Falls, and in the background you can see the Horseshoe Canadian side, and it's so beautiful! I do also want to specify that you don't need to go with a guided tour to see the attractions. You can go drive around and see each site on its own and spend as much time as you'd like to there and just pay for each one individually. For our convenience, since we were only there for one day, we figured it'd be so much easier to just park the car and then take a tour bus with a group of people and go from one place to another instead of having to worry the trouble of finding new parking and then paying repeatedly at each different site.
After taking a quick look at what we'll soon be witnessing up close in front of us, we decided to check out the Niagara Falls Power Vista, which is open from 9 a.m. to 5 p.m., free for visitors. It's a perfect center for kids to learn about how Niagara Falls came to be and the history about the place.
So currently we are at Power Vista, Niagara Power Vista, and basically it's kind of like a science museum for kids and adults. And it's free. And our tour guide told us about it so that while we wait for our tour to start, we can come here and check it out. And it looks pretty cool. So it's one of the many free activities you could do here, as well as sightseeing and seeing the main waterfall attractions.
After taking a look at everything the museum had to offer, we decided to head back to make it in time for the tour. As you can see my dad and I saying hi over here, here we're on the bus, getting started and heading toward the first item on the list, which is the Maid of the Mist ships. Here you can see the ticket prices, the adults are $25.25 and the children are $14.75 per piece.
Hi, so we just got here to the boat tour and here's what you can see so far. And then we're gonna go down that way. Over there you can see the Canadian side. Sunset and vine, you ruined my life by not being mine. You're so gorgeous, I can't say anything to your face. We're currently getting on the boat. We just got on the boat.
Particles of the rain.
Crazy. It's so beautiful.
If you're boarding the Maid of the Mist ship from the American side, as we did, the first thing you're going to see is on the left, the American 2 Falls. Both the American and the Bridal Veil Falls is on the left, and it's beautifully mesmerizing, as you can see, a scene practically from a movie. If you look closely at the American Falls, you'll also notice on the side a set of stairs. That is actually where the Cave of the Winds is located, which is another attraction we're going to see later on. Oh my goodness, and then now we're by the horseshoe, the largest one. That's the Canadian side over there. Ooh, we can actually take a second. Look how beautiful. As the ship made its way forward, next we saw the Horseshoe Falls, which is the larger one and it's located on the Canadian side. Here you can see that it's very misty and it's very hard to actually see because of all the water particles that were coming our way from the strong winds from the waterfalls.
No holding on or anything. Waterproof mascara was smart.
Another important thing to keep in mind is that anything you're going to be holding outside of the plastic jacket that they provide you with will most likely get drenched. So if you're a glasses user like I am, I do highly recommend holding them on the side just to prevent risk of dropping them or having them break.
Honest review, how is it?
Spectacular.
Super wet, super shaky.
Super
fun. Fun. I was in the mood to go to like a water park and that was so worth it. Look how beautiful in the background as well.
Truthfully, the falls were one of the most beautiful natural sights I've ever witnessed. A photo or video can't even begin to describe how I felt in that given moment, but I'm so grateful that I got to see both the American and the Canadian side of both the falls. They were both beautiful.
We got off of the boat and now we made it back up to the top to the observation deck.
And here we're going to take a bunch of nice photos and
good views that I will be showing y'all later. And yes, I'm holding my glasses. Not very water friendly, but still beautiful.
Given in its name, and as you can see over here, the observation deck shows a clear image of both the American and Horseshoe Falls, and it peers right over the ships of the Maid of the Mist that we were just on below. With the tour, we came up here, and we were able to snap a few pictures before we went on to our next destination.
Now we're over here on Goat Island, and we have a beautiful view of the Canadian side, Horseshoe Falls. So I'm gonna show you guys right now. We're walking over to it. We're gonna take a bunch of pictures, but look at that mist. Look how beautiful that is.
It looks like a big hot tub.
Yeah, like a big hot tub, as Patrick said. So yeah, really, really excited. The falls took a little bit of my makeup off, so, but waterproof mascara, very smart move. I don't know if you guys heard me earlier, but wearing water shoes was pretty smart too, though a lot of people were wearing flip-flops. What else is really important to keep in mind? Oh, for the phones, get yourself a plastic cover. My best advice, that's what I did, and personally saved me so much. People were even complimenting me. They were like, oh my goodness, you came prepared. I was like, yes, for once. So definitely recommending that to you guys. And yeah, now we're gonna go take some pictures. As I just stated, the third stop with our tour guide was Goat Island, where we got a clear view of the Horseshoe Falls. Here you can even see the path we took with the Maid of the Mist ship below that you could see right down here. After we took a few more pictures, we hopped on the bus again and made our way with the tour to our fourth stop, which was the Cave of the Winds. This is another must-see in addition to the Maid of the Mist ship that I definitely recommend seeing. Before going down to the actual Cave of the Winds, which is the stairs right beside the waterfall, first you're taken into a room to hear about the history of the falls and also the story that came along with it. With factories being built and not everyone having good intentions behind it, it was interesting to actually hear and learn about this side of the story. It is very good to see that the natural beauty of the falls was preserved and we're still able to visit them today, despite everything that they've been through. Here you'll see the beginning of the clip that gave more backstory and context to what I just mentioned before.
It is 1869, and the beauty of Niagara Falls has been overwhelmed by crass commercialism and bleak industry.
After watching the clip and learning about the importance of preserving nature, we made our way down to the actual caves. We're going to the Cave of the Winds right now, and bags ready, so should be fun. We made our way down and outside where we received another set of plastic jacket covers, and here you could see the view from where we saw the Maid of the Mist ship earlier showcasing the stairs. Now look at this view of the falls. Here I was just blowing up of excitement, and you're gonna see exactly why. So we just got to the Cave of the Winds, and it's like a stairway down, and look at that view in the back. Absolutely gorgeous. You take these stairs and you make it to the beautiful view.
Can I be honest? I still want your hands up on my body. You still make my heart beat fast. Ferrari with me in the wave, but in the morning.
Of course, here I am having a little me moment, romanticizing life, being the main character as we all should, period. Currently at the falls, and we're at the cave of, what is it called? Cave of Winds.
Cave of the Winds.
Cave of the Winds. And yeah, I think the name speaks for itself, if you can even hear me. Oh my god. Shower. I got shower. But yeah, look at this view. I said the name of the place so many times that I literally forgot it, and you'll see exactly what we were in for and why I did forget the name of the place. We made our way up, and well...
My moment, I just feel so alive.
Alive. just went to the Cave of the Winds, and absolutely, I recommend it. Look at this, first of all. If this doesn't speak for itself, I don't know what it does. Like, literally, absolutely amazing. Like, the boat was phenomenal as well, because you got to see beautiful views. But this, loved it. Loved it. Look at this. Movie moment for real.
Here's my hot girl walk slash also trying not to slip and fall because I'm all wet walk.
We just finished the Cave of the Winds. Absolutely amazing. If you could describe it in one word, what would you say?
Cold and wet.
Chaotic.
Amazing. And if you guys had to pick to go or to recommend for someone to go, would you say the boat or would you say the caves?
Cave.
It depends. Picture is more boat. But at the same time, I absolutely love this. And you get to, it's kind of like self-guided. You could stay kind of however long you want unless you're on a tour. So I can't pick. I'd say both. Do both. Okay, so we're waiting to hop on the bus right now, and I will say that it was a good experience, especially because there weren't that many people. Now, it's important to keep in mind that it's Wednesday and like almost 8 p.m., so maybe that's why, but I do recommend not going on the weekends for that reason if you're looking to take more, like take your time more, you know, because I feel like during the weekends it'll probably be more busy, but I'm sure any day that you come, the experience will still be amazing. It's been a really great experience so far, and we're not quite done just yet.
Our fifth destination of the night was Three Sisters Island.
That's Luna Island. Luna Island is separating Bridal Veil from the American Falls. We're actually right here at Three Sisters Island. Like I said, it's four islands to get a bigger view. These outer islands we'll be walking across. One, two, three, four. So all three are sisters and their younger brother. So we're going to go down to the end.
It was pretty dark by the time we went to see the Three Sisters Islands, but I will say that in comparison to the other sightseeing we did throughout the day, the Three Sisters Islands is very simplistic. It's more for strolling around, taking pictures of smaller waterfalls. It was still very peaceful and enjoyable nonetheless, but just more simplistic in comparison to more of the outgoing exotic adventures we did earlier.
Anyway, today was a great success, and I'm happy you guys tagged along with me. We're gonna keep going with this, and I'm sure you guys are gonna love the rest as well. Okay, at night the observatory is for free, so we're gonna go head up there and see the fireworks and the view. We were here earlier today, which we did have to pay for, which we went to after the boats, but now you get to come up for free and you get to see the beautiful views of the falls and the floodlights, and the fireworks show, which is done every single day as well as these lights are done every day, is at 10 o'clock from 10 to 10:05 approximately. It's only 5 minutes. They're behind the falls like me. They actually come from that perspective over there. State Park, and we just watched the fireworks and the lead light waterfalls, and it was absolutely beautiful. And okay, yeah, we had a great time. Oh, we gotta run, we gotta catch the bus.
Can we eat? All right, you guys, this is a certificate from me saying that you completed the tour. You guys, thank you for riding with us. I got some postcards.
Thank you so much.
Take it back home.
Okay, did everyone have a great time?
Yeah.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
100%. Okay. Comfy, cozy, snacks and blankets, and we're ready to get going home. Another 5-hour drive.
It is currently 1 a.m. We are at a gas station and debating whether we should go to a motel. We have 2 more hours on the road. We drove 130 miles. There's 180 left for us. So we'll see. We ultimately decided to just keep driving and make it home safely, despite the pouring rain that came out of nowhere. I will have to say, though, that I am proud of us for driving the 5 to 6 hours there, spending the whole day visiting attractions, and then the 5 to 6 hour drive back. I think it's safe to say we're all going to sleep. What is it, 3:50 in the morning?
We are one crazy family.
Good night, y'all. Oh my gosh. See you tomorrow morning, or good afternoon now. It's currently almost 3 p.m. here on my end. I tried to film a video kind of concluding earlier, but the weather did not cooperate. Anyways, so now it's looking nice and sunny over here in PA. Yesterday we ended up getting back around 3:30 in the morning, pretty late. I think I went to sleep at 4:30, really, really late. But it was definitely worth it, despite the drive, 5 hours there, 5 hours back. It was really great. It was an awesome experience, a beautiful trip that I'm happy I got to take you guys along with me on. I just wanted to say thank you for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed it as much as I enjoyed filming it. And if you guys have any advice, comments, or anything on videos like these with traveling, or any questions, I will be more than happy to answer them. You can put them down below. Oh my god, I always want to say that. Just like you're watching Disney Channel. If you like these type of videos, you know what to do. Just hit that button. But yeah, this place is just for us to all be open with one another, become awesome friends, and for me to share some stuff that I do with you guys, hopefully for you guys to enjoy this type of entertainment. Also, feel free to check out my Instagram and TikTok at Nicole Ogrodnik. I post about pretty places, motivational affirmations, fun transitions, dances, latest trends on my Reels tab. And yeah, if I'm happy, you're happy, the world's happy, then life's great, you know? I will see y'all in the next video. Bye!